You're probably familiar with histograms and what they tell you as far as getting the correct exposure is concerned, but some actual dedicated video cameras have what's called a waveform view, which is a bit like a histogram, but not exactly the same. So let me just bring that up on the screen. It's in menu, of course, video mode. And if we go to page 3, just scale through there like that, waveform monitor, turn it on with a click of the joystick. Like that, and you'll see this little box here. Now there's a couple of things to point out. First of all, if I long press and then I can stretch it by pinching my fingers in and out like that, making it really big, or I can make it really small, and I can float it around the screen as well and place it somewhere more useful out of the way if you're using it a lot. So it obviously does obscure part of the picture if you make it nice and big. But let me just make it nice and big so we can see what's going on. So I'll just place that down at the bottom there. And just a long press to register it there. Okay, so what we're looking at, and that's the camera is only really pointing at my computer keyboard and screen, but as I change the exposure, you'll see very clearly that these bright areas here, or the brightest parts of the picture, are actually shown in this display as this line here. And as they go up and down, you'll see that I'm making the highlights brighter or darker. And if I go too high, they will clip. If I come down to about there, it's probably about right. What you can see in this display is two thicker green bars at 100% and 50%, and then four dotted lines in between each of those, which give you 10 steps. So the top line is the 100% mark. But more importantly, if I move the camera left and right, can you see the whole waveform display moves with the image? That's because the left-hand side of the waveform relates to the left-hand side of the picture, the center to the center of the picture, and the right-hand side to the right-hand side of a picture. So if you look carefully, where that screen curves up to the top of the screen there, that is that little curve there. The extension of that white area there is the desk. So if I just turn, if I move that out of the way, I'll just make it a bit smaller, you'll see this desk here is that continuation, and then that area there stops at that point and it's dark to the left, and that's that area there. So you can interpret the picture quite accurately. But most importantly, you will set your exposure by judging that waveform in that sense. And one cool thing you might want to do is, let me just come to the custom buttons. Now, you may know, if you already have an SL2S or an SL2, that if you long press one of the custom buttons, there's various ones, there's two on the front to the left of the finger grip, it's a rocker switch. I'm going to press the bottom and hold it, and now you'll see I've chosen waveform monitor. So when I come out of the custom function there, and I click the bottom button under the rocker switch there, I'm turning the waveform on and off. And when it's off, I'm seeing a histogram, and when it's on, I'm not seeing a histogram. So I can actually choose either view depending on the task I want to perform. So that's a really, really useful way of judging your exposures, and videographers find it works really well. Personally, I find histograms and waveforms about equal in their use, but very occasionally it's really useful to be able to see which part of the picture is the brightest, which a histogram can't tell you. And that's where waveform display will come into play most effectively. The tally frame, or the recording frame, is very easy to explain. It's best if I just show you. If we go into the menus, well, let me just show you on the screen first. When you're recording, there's a tiny little grey dot just there, which flashes red when you're recording. It's kind of hard to see from a distance. So if you go into menu and you go to video settings, and you need to go to the next page, it says rec frame, recording frame. Turn that on. Come out of the menus, and then when I hit the record button up here, you'll see around the outside of the screen is a red frame. That's the recording frame, the tally frame, and now you can see from a lot further away that you're actually recording. Very, very useful, and might help you in circumstances when you're working remotely, triggering the camera with, say, the Leica Photos app on your phone or something like that. The last feature we'll talk about in this video are the color bars. And what this does is the camera will generate a test chart signal with color bars and also an audio tone at a certain loudness measured in decibels. So let me just show you what that looks like. So we go into the menu, go into video settings, and at the bottom you'll see color bar. Now you do have some choices, And I'll just explain what those are. The SMPTE pattern is on the left, the Arab pattern is on the right, and the main difference is with the Arab pattern, there's some extra grey patches. So at the far left and the far right, there's a 40% grey, underneath it's a 70% grey, and there are some darker patches underneath that, which give you the chance to set your contrast and brightness of your external monitor such that you can just about see the differences between those very, very dark grey patches. That's how you actually calibrate the brightness and the contrast of your monitor. So personally, I quite like the Arab ones. Turn those on now. Now you won't be able to hear it through my microphone, but it's now making this beep noise and it's set to minus 20 dB. I can change that to minus 18 or minus 12. Now you can use that as a signal to calibrate audio equipment, just like you can use the color bar to actually calibrate your external monitors to make sure they're all showing the same picture. So this is for high-end productions where you have a whole bunch of other equipment that you need to make sure is working perfectly in sync and everything is just right. For somebody recording with a single camera as is, may not be that useful, but it's nice to know it's there.